Hello and welcome to my channel April Flower Arts. I'm Tushara. Today I'm going to share with you my recipe for a very popular chicken curry, that is chicken tikka masala. It consists of small bite-sized marinated chicken pieces which is grilled in tandoor oven and then simmered in a very smooth and creamy onion and tomato gravy. But today I'm going to show you how to make it easily at home on stovetop without any tandoor oven or grill. So let's see how to make it. So let's start with the marination process. Here I've taken about 500 grams of chicken. I've cut them into small bite-sized pieces. These are boneless chicken pieces. For the marination, you will need 1/2 tablespoon of ginger paste, 1 tablespoon of garlic paste, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder. And these two are optional ingredients, that is 1/2 teaspoon of dried fenugreek leaves, that is kasuri methi, and 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala powder. We'll also take some salt, about 1/2 teaspoon. I'll also squeeze in some lime juice, about 1 tablespoon. Give it a good mix. We'll now add this marinade into the chicken and we'll coat the chicken pieces really well with the marinade. Make sure that all of the chicken pieces are coated really well. Alright, the chicken pieces are coated really well with the marinade. Now into this we'll add about 1/4 cup of thick yogurt, plain yogurt, that is curd or dahi, and mix it in really well. We'll let it sit for about 1/2 hour. While the chicken is marinating, we'll prepare the other ingredients required for the gravy. Finely chopped onions, which comes to about 2 cups, and pureed tomato about 1 cup. These two form the base of the gravy. You may even take finely chopped tomatoes or blend 2 or 3 ripe tomatoes into fine paste and run it through a strainer to get a smooth paste like this. You will need some more spices for the gravy. 1 teaspoon each of garlic paste, ginger paste, red chili powder, garam masala powder, coriander powder, 1/2 teaspoon each of turmeric powder and cumin powder, and optional ingredient, dried fenugreek leaves or kasuri methi. Some whole spices such as a bay leaf, 1 green cardamom or elaichi, 4 to 5 cloves, 1 inch piece of cinnamon stick, and some diced veggies. These are optional. I've taken here some green bell peppers or capsicum, onions and tomatoes. I've removed the seeds. Finely chopped coriander leaves or cilantro and cashew paste. I've soaked about 15 cashews overnight and blended it into a smooth paste. Alternatively, you may use heavy cream, that is also known as milk cream or malai. Alright, we'll start with the cooking process. Here I have a pan heating up at medium to high heat. We need to grill the marinated chicken on the pan. Here I've taken non-stick pan, so I'm not adding any oil because the marinade contains yogurt. If you're not using a non-stick pan, you may add a few drops of oil, about 1 tablespoon or so. And place the chicken pieces. So we'll now grill the chicken on both sides for about 5 minutes on each side first. Alright, it's been about 5 minutes. So the chicken will leave out a lot of juices and its own fat. We'll now flip the pieces around. We'll cook the other side as well for about 5 minutes. So after about 5 to 6 minutes, you see that the chicken has dried up very well and got a nice brown color on both sides. We'll remove the chicken from the pan. We'll now set aside the grilled chicken pieces. In the same pan, we'll grill the diced vegetables as well. First, we'll add in the onions. I have not added any oil, but you may add few drops if you wish. Just grill them for about few seconds. We'll keep the heat at medium to high. After few seconds, we'll add the bell peppers or capsicum and grill them for few more seconds. So after about a minute, we'll add the tomatoes as well and grill them for few more seconds. We need not cook the vegetables completely, we just grill them from the outside and maintain the crispiness of the vegetables. Make sure that the tomatoes don't get very mushy. Now we'll set aside the grilled vegetables as well. In the next step, we'll prepare the gravy. We'll add about 2 to 3 tablespoons of cooking oil. When the oil heats up, we'll keep the heat at low to medium and add the whole spices, the bay leaves, cinnamon, cloves. I'll just open up the green cardamom and add it. About 1/2 teaspoon of salt to cook the onions faster. We'll saute the onions at medium to high. When the onions soften a bit, we'll add the ginger and garlic paste and continue sauteing. We'll saute until the onions get a nice brown color. So So this gives a nice color to the gravy and flavor as well. I'm also gonna add finely chopped green chilies. I have two green chilies here, but it's totally optional, or you can add it as per your taste. We now add all the powdered spices, the red chili powder, turmeric, coriander, cumin, garam masala powder. At this point, we'll keep them heat at minimum and quickly saute the spices just for a few seconds, or else you'll burn them, and immediately add the tomatoes. Mix it in and we'll let the gravy cook for about 10 minutes on medium heat, or until the oil separates from the gravy. The oil has separated from the gravy, so we say that the masala is no longer sticking to the pan. It just slides off easily like this. So this is what we are looking for. So this means the gravy is completely cooked. This is an important step for the perfect flavor of the gravy. At this point, you can do a few things. That is, if you have not chopped the onions very finely, and if you want a very smooth gravy, you can run it in a blender by adding some water and turn it into a smooth paste. If you wish, you may also fish out the whole spices such as the bay leaf and cinnamon. Since I've added finely chopped onions and tomato puree, I'm not gonna blend it. I'm just gonna add some water. Here I have about 2 cups, approximately 450 ml of water. We'll keep the gravy a little thin, because when we add the chicken, it will absorb a little water and the gravy will become even more thick. I think I'll add another cup of water now. So totally I've added 3 cups, approximately 700 ml of water, and we'll let it come to a boil. Alright, the gravy has started to boil. At this point, we'll reduce the heat to low and add the chicken pieces. We'll now cover and let the chicken cook in the gravy for about 5 minutes. Alright, the chicken has been cooking in the gravy for about 5 minutes. The chicken has soaked up some of the water from the gravy and the gravy has thickened up. At this point, I'm gonna add the dried fenugreek leaves or kasuri methi. This gives an amazing flavor to the chicken tikka masala, but totally optional. Next, I'm gonna add the cashew paste. Alternatively, you may use heavy cream or malai, that is milk cream, or you can add both heavy cream and cashew paste as well. It's when you add the cashew paste or heavy cream that you get the typical orange color of the gravy. The purpose of adding the cream or cashew paste is to not only get a nice, rich and creamy, smooth gravy, but also it tones down the spices and also balances the sourness from the tomatoes. And we'll cook it for one more minute. At this point, you may taste the gravy and adjust the salt as per your taste. And finally, I'm gonna add the grilled vegetables. Switch off the stove and finish it off with some chopped coriander leaves or cilantro. That's it, the chicken tikka masala is ready. So that was my recipe for homemade chicken tikka masala. Hope you liked it. If you do so, please give it a thumbs up. You can serve this chicken tikka masala with any of the Indian breads such as chapati, naan, as well as basmati rice. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notifications as soon as I upload a new video. Until next time, it's bye from me. Thanks for watching.